What do horse saddles and cooling towers have in common? More than you might think. These two common objects share a unique property. They are ruled surfaces. But what are ruled surfaces, and why do they matter? This video aims to teach you about just that. The basic idea of a ruled surface is extremely simple. It's a surface traced out by a line moving in space, like this example here of a cone. In general, surfaces are described by a function like this one, which takes in two variables and outputs a point in three-dimensional space called a vector. However, there is some more mathematical nuance to the definition of a ruled surface. All ruled surfaces are described by this equation. If you don't speak math, this equation essentially states that a ruled surface is a surface defined by a set of lines, called its rulings, whose paths follow some set curve, called the directrix, as well as some other curve, called the director, which describes the directions of the rulings. Here's how it looks when we label them on the cone example. However, cones aren't the only ruled surfaces. Let's look at some other common examples. Arguably, one of the simplest ruled surfaces is the cylinder. Its directrix and director are both circles. To make it, just connect two circles with vertical lines. However, when one of the circles is twisted a half turn, something entirely new emerges. This new shape is called a hyperboloid of one sheet, or just a hyperboloid for you and me. You may recognize it as being the shape of cooling towers. Even though we're only looking at a small piece here, its rulings and the surface itself extend indefinitely. The equation of the hyperboloid is rather interesting, so I think I'll take a moment to describe it. Much like the basic trig functions sine and cosine give the coordinates of a point on the circle, there exist a pair of functions called hyperbolic sine and hyperbolic cosine which do the same thing for the right half of a hyperbola. I won't go into much detail about how these functions work, but I will link some resources below. To get a hyperboloid from a hyperbola, all that has to be done is to spin it around some axis and trace its path in space. Thus, the hyperboloid is what's called a surface of revolution, and this fact can be seen in the equation of its surface, which basically spins the right half of a hyperbola defined using the aforementioned functions around the y-axis. The next detour on our ruled surface journey is the hyperbolic paraboloid. Its directrix and director are the edges of a tetrahedron. To make it, connect two opposite edges of the tetrahedron using lines like so, and a surface will emerge. Hyperbolic paraboloids are the shapes of Pringles and horse saddles. If you've seen string art like this, this is sort of like a 3D version of it. Here's a higher fidelity 3D render of it. It has a couple of interesting properties as well. As before, it extends indefinitely, but we're only looking at a small piece of it. For one, it's doubly ruled. That is to say, there is more than one way to draw the rulings so that they will still lie on the original surface. For another, its equation is ludicrously simple. In Cartesian coordinates, it's just z equals xy. The equation of the surface looks like this, which is essentially just a version of that. Ruled surfaces can be made with more exotic directrices as well. This next one is a shining example of that. Start with a helix. Then draw lines through the helix and the axis through its center. This ruled surface is called a helicoid. It's the shape of screws and spiral staircases. and it's by far my favorite ruled surface. Here's a higher fidelity version of it. Mathematicians usually think of this surface extending infinitely in all directions, but for simplicity, we've made a small piece of it. Much like the other surfaces we've shown so far, it has a couple of unique properties. Firstly, the helicoid isn't just defined by a single helix. An infinite number of helices lie on it. Secondly, its equation is quite cool. A helix is really just the path traced out by a point rotating at some speed, like so. The equation of a helix in terms of some parameter phi essentially just puts this statement into math using cosine and sine functions at certain frequencies. Even though we drew our segment of the helicoid using line segments, the actual helicoid is described by lines, which are of infinite length. We get the equation of a helicoid by adding a t parameter to the helix equation, allowing us to stretch the rulings out to infinity and producing the helicoid in all of its glory. Take a strip of paper. Turn one end of it a half twist, then tape the ends together. What you get is a mathematical object from topology called the Möbius strip. The Möbius strip is one-sided, as can be seen by the fact that I can draw a line all the way around the entire thing without ever picking up my pen. The Möbius strip is also a ruled surface. We can construct it mathematically using a modified version of what we've done before. Start with a circle. Then draw vertical lines through it. Next, twist the lines a half twist to get a Möbius strip. The equation for the Möbius strip mirrors this. We can see from construction that its directrix is a circle with radius r. To get the Möbius strip equation, we first observe that the director path turns a half turn relative to the directrix, giving this equation for it. Plugging this into the ruled surface formula and factoring out the cosines and sines, we get this equation for the Möbius strip. Even though this video is short, this took a lot of work. I've never made anything in 3D before, and my engine is quite rudimentary, so I used what I had. Well, hope you enjoyed. Happy holidays.